Great advantage to my clients. and by illness means I have many influential visitors. In fact, I have one at this moment. This is the chief clerk of the court. He's come to see me in spite of being such a busy man. And no doubt he'll be able to contribute and most usefully to our discussion. I can't stay very much longer. I'll go and see what's happening.
Kissed me. would you do this to yourself? Have you any idea how you've damaged your case? You crept off with that little bitch. Well, obviously, he's old business, and you're gone for hours. Meanwhile, waiting in that room, there's me, who's gone through so much trouble for you. There's your lawyer, who doesn't know what to say, and above all, the chief clerk of the court. A man who at the moment is actually in charge of your case, and so nothing was said. These are men of the world. But finally, the chief clerk of the court stood up and took his case. Kind man, clearly sorry for me. I, by then, could scarcely breathe, and Holt was speechless too. He was looking really ill. Come on, let's get out of here.
Wait! It's where to find the painter, and here is the key to the building. Come whenever you
long ago, but they provide me this atelier for free. Are you here to buy a painting, or do you want your portrait done? I'm working on something new.
About the court. Never mind, I'll get you off.
You said Just now it was impossible to convince the court.
Impossible to convince the court!
But possible, informally, behind the scenes.
Yes, I see what you mean. The first thing to establish is what results you're looking for. There are three possibilities. Genuine acquittal, apparent acquittal, or postponement. Genuine acquittal is, of course, the best, but in all my years in court, I haven't seen or heard of it.
I see. Then what's the point of all the court? Why not have a single executioner? As you were saying, it's apparent acquittal or postponement. Take off your jacket.
Please put it on his jacket. It will mend.
not this way if I were you. Might I interest you in a painting? This one's a landscape. I'll take it. What about this one? A companion piece. I'll take them both. And this one. Yes. What do I owe you for the three? We'll discuss it next time. Here, you may as well take them all. I can see you have an eye for this sort of thing. I'll send my assistant for them in the morning. I'll help you get them downstairs.
Cicarelli, let us in! Cicarelli, let us in!
Exactly like the law courts. That's because it is. There are law courts in practically every attic in the city.
Come back, Tisarelli. Come back. Come back, Tisarelli.
Is Lenny your mistress?
Good heavens, no!
What's her name?
Flock, I'm a businessman.
Flock, is that your real name?
Yes, why would it not be?
Where is Lenny hiding?
She's not hiding anywhere. In fact, here she is.
Joseph
Fenner! Good evening. Who's that?
Oh, look! Just look at him!
You were in your nightdress. Is he your lover? Answer me! Don't try to kiss me!
You can't be jealous of poor Block!
No, I suppose not.
Well, I want to see Herr Gould. He's not well today. But let him know you're here. Only thing is to spend the night with me. Let's get your coat on. Should I take him your
hair?
Or first should I take him his soul?
Take him his soul. He'll need his strength for what I'm going to say.
He usually goes to sleep right after he's eaten.
What I'm going to tell him will keep him awake all night. Now get on with it.
I need to be hostile.
Don't get up. How long has Gould been representing you?
Since the start of my trial, more than 5 years ago.
You must be one of his most faithful clients.
Well, not exactly faithful.
What do you mean?
I probably shouldn't tell you. He can be very vindictive.
I think you should risk it.
I tell you, you have to promise to tell me a secret about you and him so that we even
agreed.
All right. He's not my only lawyer.
She's at home. What's so bad about that?
It's not allowed. You're only allowed one designated lawyer. But I have six, counting me.
Why on earth would you need that many?
I don't don't want to lose my pride, so I've spent everything I've ever earned. See, I'm a businessman, I look for tangible results. So I complained to my lawyer, and he explained that to us was something specific, like a definite trial date would be catastrophic. So I began to turn to other lawyers, who by the way confirmed what he said. Still I've never regretted hiring the others, although they're all what the court describes as small lawyers, including Dr. Hurt, who is rather neat. So for great lawyers, great lawyers, where can they be found? Don't even try it. It's probably impossible to contact them. They choose their own cases.
So you stopped trying to find them?
I did, of course. You never quite forget them. I think of them sometimes at night.
You two seem to be getting on.
He wanted to talk about my trial.
The world is waiting to see you. You can talk to me.
Staying the night.
He often does. Not everyone sees the heart when they lie.
His face is much more interesting than mine.
Sometimes Brooke is here for 3 days before we see him, but he enjoys sleeping here.
You've forgotten. You promised us.
All right, I'm going to dismiss my lawyer.
He's going to dismiss him. He's going to dismiss his lawyer.
This is the last time I see you so late at night.
I believe it is.
Sit down. Lenny hasn't been importuning you, has she?
Importuning me?
She can't help herself.
She finds dependence irresistibly attractive.
But in fact, defendants often are. It's why you can pick them out in a crowd. They are simply the most attractive people. It can't be their guilt or their impending fate. It must be something in them in the first place. Even that poor wretched Block is attractive. Was there something special you wanted to see me about?
Yes, I'd like you to know that from today I no longer want you to represent me. I've considered this carefully. My decision is final.
Could you pass me that blanket? Believe me, I understand your impatience.
I'm not impatient.
But you remember when my uncle first brought me to you. I wasn't much concerned about my trial, but once you began to represent me, I became quite obsessed. Thoughts of my trial never leave my head. You'd never guess how many of my clients at this very stage have come to me and said what you're saying.
I'd say they were right.
I was about to say I hoped for better judgment from you. But I see you've lost confidence in me. I take on very few new clients these days. I find I must devote myself entirely in order to achieve success. I've never in the least begrudged this effort.
If I retain your services, what will you do for me?
What I've been doing up till now.
Then there's nothing more to be said.
Wait, one more thing. I think you're making this mistake because you've been too well treated. I'm going to speak to Block now. Sit down and watch.
Very well. As long as you understand, you no longer represent me.
We'll see. Lenny, fetch Block!
Block! Help me!
What do you want? This is not a good moment.
I thought I was sent for.
You were, but it's not a good moment. Why is it you never come at a good moment?
Do you want me to leave?
No, as long as you're here, you may as well stay. Yesterday, I was with my friend, the third judge, when the conversation drifted around to you. Do you want to know what he said?
Please, please!
Don't do that! You mustn't kneel to him!
Who is your lawyer? And apart from me,
no one else, sir. Only you.
Then pay no attention to anyone else.
All right, crawl on all fours if you like. It's nothing to do with me.
You can't speak to me like that. You're no better than me. You don't try,
no, sir.
And hold, listen to how this man speaks to me.
Take no notice of anyone else. Just what seems right to you.
Thank you. Let go. You're hurting me.
I don't think that I can tell him.
Tell him what?
Has he behaved himself today?
Yes, he's been very quiet. Kept himself busy. I locked him in the bedroom. Is the father reading those documents you left him?
And did he understand them?
I can't say. They probably had hard to understand.
They are. You won't have understood a word of them.
When he started them, more or less without a break.
This is why it's so hard to tell him that what the judge said about his case was not all that positive.
Not positive?
No, he was annoyed with me for mentioning his name.
don't talk to me about Glock. He said he's taking advantage of you. No, I said, he works on his trial all the time. I know he's disagreeable and none too clean. But as regards the conduct of his trial, he's beyond reproach. The judge said he's cunning, that's all. But his ignorance is greater than his cunning. What do you think he'd say if he found out that after all this time, his trial hasn't even started yet? Down, Block! Why are you panicking? I've a good mind not to tell you anything else. You're still alive, aren't you? And under my protection, your feet disgust me. Have you no faith? It's just a remark by one judge. I'm dealing with it. Don't show me up in front of my client.
Doc, stop fiddling with the rug and listen to what Harold is telling you.
Everyone involved in these proceedings seems
prejudiced against me.
No, you misunderstand. The verdict is not suddenly pronounced. It slowly falls from the proceedings.
So that's the way of it.
So what are your plans?
I intend to look for outside help.
For too much outside help already, especially from women.
Women have great influence, above all on the court officials, the vast majority of whom are lecturers. Are you angry with me? I'm only going on my own experience.
Can't you see two steps in front of your nose?
Can't you come down from there?
Very well.
I feel I can speak openly to you.
You mustn't delude yourself.
How am I deluding myself?
Your delusion is described in one of the introductory writings on the law. A doorkeeper stands guarding the law. A man from the country arrives and asked to be admitted. Not now, the doorkeeper says. What about later, the man asks. Possibly, but not now. The gate is open, so the man leans forward to look in. The doorkeeper laughs. Go ahead if you want to go in. You can try, even though I've forbidden it. But think about this, I may be the lowest of the doorkeepers, but I'm strong. From gate to gate the doorkeepers get more trouble. I got even better look. He feels the law should be accessible to all. But he thinks he'd better wait to be admitted. The doorkeeper issues him a stool. He waits for death. Accepts, saying, I don't want you to think you've left a stone unturned. Over the years, he forgets about the doorkeepers. And this one, who's very fleecy, tries to recruit to change their master's mind. Now seems the sole obstacle to his quest. Finally, he can't tell whether his eyes are growing weaker or the darkness is really setting in. Everything is
been through crystallizes into a single question. He beckons to the doorkeeper, who has to crouch to hear his failing voice. Now what the doorkeeper asks, you're never satisfied. The man says, everyone yearns to meet the Lord. So why all these many years? No one but me has asked you for admittance. The doorkeeper can see the man is fading. He shouts his answer to be sure he's heard. Nobody else could ever come through here, because this gaze is meant for you alone. Now I shall close it.
are you playing at this week?
Theatre.
You look like a couple of tenors.
Isn't it your birthday?
Tomorrow I would have been 31. What may then send you of all people? I'm not going one more step.
End of The Trial by Philip Glass. Joseph K, on the eve of his 31st birthday, finally accepts his fate. Michael Rafferty conducted the Music Theatre Wales Ensemble, and the voices we've been hearing this evening aren't Here and Now. Johnny Hereford as Joseph K, and the other roles sung by Amanda Forbes, Rowan Hellier, Paul Kuriavici, Michael Bennett, Gwion Thomas, Nicholas Falwell, and Michael Druitt. This performance by Music Theatre Wales, directed by Michael McCarthy, was recorded live in the Limbury Studio Theatre at the Royal Opera House in London, following the world premiere there on the 10th of October. And the opera, The Trial, is a co-commission and a co-production by Music Theatre Wales, the Royal Opera, Theatre Magdeburg, and Scottish Opera.